Swear. Hi, Ian. Can you hear me?
Hi, how are you?
Very good, thank you. The very first question, Ian. You're 13, 37 years of age. You've been in the UFC for the past 5 years, almost six, but you seem to, let's say, never have been any better. What happened last year?
What happened? I think I'm just, you know, mentally and physically best shape ever, you know. I just find the way. I know my body, I know myself better than never, and I find a way how to be the best in the world right now, and I think this is what's happening, you know. Everything, I think also my life, not only in the gym, but outside the gym, is pretty good right now, almost brilliant, so it's also, I think, this helped me a lot, because I like to, you know, have a peace in my, around me, you know, and when I start, when that happened, everything is really good, you know, and that's why I am the place, one of the best in the world right now, and I have the chance to be the best in the world right now.
Exactly. So in less than 2 weeks, you will have the chance to fight for the world title. And so you were on a four-fight winning streak before your loss to against Thiago Santos. Did that one help you make the necessary adjustments?
Yes, of course, because like I told you before, I know myself much better, you know. And I know where I do mistakes when I lose the fight, and I know how to fix it, to don't do this mistake anymore, you know. And thanks to Thiago, I'm better fighter right now, much better, you know.
And what were those mistakes exactly?
You know, it's long story, you know, because I tried to change my whole training gym, training camps, and that was first big mistake. Then I start doing weird dietics, you know. Okay. Another mistake, you know. And I need to find why I'm doing this, for what, when I do some things before, I don't use this special diet and stuff. It was everything perfect. So I just back to this is what I want to say. I back to roots, and now I am one of the best in the world, you know.
Exactly.
I don't start, you know, do weird techniques and weird thing in my preparation. Mm.
And you have 26 wins in your career, 7 by way of knockout, but you've been very vocal about the legendary Polish power. So what is it exactly?
In my muscles. And legendary Polish power is, you know, it's something what Polish people have got in the hearts, you know. They just the Polish people, they have to find it, and they have to find a way how to, you know, release the legendary Polish power. And I think that I find it, and finally I release it, and you're gonna see it again in soon.
And would you say that you come from a land of fighters?
Yeah, you know. You know the Polish history. We have to fight all our life, I think, so, you know, when you check our history. They attack us from everywhere, you know, and we have to defend, protect our country. And that's why we've got this, you know, this is legendary Polish power. We've got this, the pride, and we are just the fighters. You cannot stop us. We always survive, you know.
And I've seen your last vlog on your YouTube channel, and apparently you're touching rope from a hangman for luck. What is this?
Yeah. You know, because when I find him in the forest, I have to call for police, you know, because they have to take him out, check what happened. And when I spoke with police guy and he asked me, how do I find him and stuff like this, he asked me, did I take piece of the road to my home after everything. And I said, what do you say? Why? For what? You are crazy? And he, no, it's really good. I've got my piece of road with me all the time when I go to first guy like this. You know, I but for what? And because this bring luck. And I watch on him and say, well, okay. And I check it on internet, you know.
Okay.
It's a lot of things on internet. You can check it. The people in old times, long time ago, they believed that if you've got, you know, the piece of rope of hanging person, it bring you luck. And I start touching. I don't take it. I just come to this place and touch it. And yeah, it worked.
And when did that happen exactly?
I think if my memory is really good, before Jimmy Manuari match.
Oh, so yeah, so it worked. It went quite well. And so in a bit more than a week, you're fighting Dominic Reyes for the world title. He represents the next generation of fighters, of course, but you were supposed to face John Jones, of course, who represents another generation of fighters. If you had to choose between them, who would have been your opponent?
I think everybody wants to beat John Jones, you know, because, you know, he is the one who have the belt long time. Nobody beat him. But I don't have, you know, choose. I've got Dominic and I'm always happy to fight against him. It's also a pleasure for me because he's also really good fighter, one of the best in the world. He almost beat John Jones. So it's great for me. I'm happy that I got, you know, Dominic Reyes. I catch John Jones later. He don't escape me. I find him. Don't worry. But right now, I'm focused only about Dominic. And that's it. He is only in my head right now.
And we can expect fireworks from this fight. And you fought the who's who of the division for a lot of years, from Jimmy Manua to Alexander Gustafsson in the UFC and KSW. And who has been your most challenging opponent and your most challenging fights, of course?
In KSW, I think that was Sokoju.
Okay.
But in UFC, I think so that was Jimmy Manua, both fight against him. His style and my style was really good, you know. And just, you know, the second fight was brilliant, you know.
Yeah.
Amazing, you know. Bloody fight, you know.
Exactly, really back and forth.
For this fight to end of my life.
And so you...
Also, after when I beat him in the rematch, I started, you know, something changed in my mind and I believe a little bit more in myself, you know. And I believe that after this fight, I know that I can beat everybody and nothing can stop me right now. Before the Jimmy Manu, I have question. I have to ask myself, you know, this is my level. I can beat him or no, you know. But I start to believe, no, this is, I can beat him. I can beat everybody. And when I beat him and I take a rematch, I start believing myself much more. Okay. If I beat him, I can beat everybody, you know, because he beat me in first time, in our first fight. You know?
Exactly.
So, and I, after the rematch, I knew that not sky is the limit, but your mind is the limit, and everything is in your head. And I just, you know, right, my mind is free, and I knew that I can do everything what I want to do.
And a lot of light heavyweights are moving up to the heavyweight division. And is that something that could interest you in the future?
In the future, yes. Right now, no, but in the future, I think for sure I will do a couple of fights in heavyweight. I think this is my, you know, my destiny because I hate to get in weight. I love food. I love to eat.
And you've been able to unlock some new skills over the years, but you've lost your very first MMA fight before going to KSW. At that time, was it a difficult challenge to overcome?
I don't remember. It was a long time ago. But okay. Always after the losing is hard, you know. But after the losing, you need to just thinking what was wrong. Why I lost the fight? What happened? And if you knew that, you're going to be better fighter. If you don't find the problem, you're not going to be better fighter. Mm. I think that I always, after the losing, I find a way how to... what was problem? What goes wrong? And when I find this, I change this. I don't do this mistake anymore. And look around. Where am I now? On the top, you know, almost on the top. One more step, and I will.
Exactly,
on
just one more step, one more victory, and I have one last question. So people sometimes speak about the behavior of fighters. They say that they are not like regular, normal people, but you seem very calm with a pretty normal life. And how did you find that balance between the craziness of the octagon and the life in Poland?
The balance is really important in your life, you know. You need to, you know, you have to train hard, but also you have to remember about the recovery. And this is, you know, and also you can eat some shit, but you can don't too much, you know. You need to also eat healthy food. You can drink 2 beers, but not too much, you know. The balance for me is really important. And, you know, right now I'm calm and, you know, nice guy, but when the octagon will close, I will, you know, change something in my head like this, and I will be not nice for Dominic, you know. I will try to knock him out, and I will do this. I believe that I can do this.
And how does it happen, the switch between the normal Jan and the dangerous Jan, and then switching it back off?
You know, it's, I don't know, you know, I do this long time, so I just know how to do this. Everybody's different, you know, it's not like a secret. You need to find how to do this, you know. And I find that I know how to do this, and just, if I'm gonna need to do this right now, you know, if someone come to my room, like, I don't know, someone to store my things, I will change my head in the same moment, you know, and I will stop him, you know, yeah, like this, you know, it's, I know how to do this.
Well then, perfect. Thank you very much, Jan, and good luck for Saturday night.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Swear.